Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum dear students. How are you? Fine. I hope you are fine and health and enjoying your winter season at home. Today we are going to start prime numbers and composite numbers. As we have yesterday learned division. Now it's our page number 54. It's about prime number and composite numbers. So let me remind you that prime numbers are the numbers that have only two factors. One factor is the number 1 and the second factor is the number itself. For example, 3. 3 has only two factors, 1 and 3 itself. For example, 5. 5 has only two factors, 1 and the 5 itself. So prime numbers are the numbers those have only two factors. First factor is the 1 and second factor the number itself. And on the other hand, composite numbers are the numbers that have more than two factors. If there are only two factors, this will be prime number. And remember, if there are more than three factors, more than two factors, three or more than three factors, then it will be a composite number. For example, number 4. Number 4 have 1, 2, and 4, three factors. Okay, so these are prime numbers and composite numbers. Open your book, page number 54. This is question number 3. And we have to select the factors. Look at the numbers. Are they prime? Are they composite? Write your answer in your notebook. Simply you can write on the book, if 35 is prime, write in front of 35, that is P. Or if it is composite, write in front, which is C. C for composite, okay? You can solve this on book by writing small p and small c in front of the numbers. Understand? So let's check 35 is a composite number or prime number. Question number 3, part A, 35. So first we will check how many factors it can have. 1, 5, 7 and 35. These are the tables in which 35 comes. Factors means in which tables the numbers comes. So 35 comes in the table of 1, 35 must come in the tables of 5, 35 must come in the table of 7, and 35 itself will be a factor. So as it has more than two factors, 1, 2, 3, 4, so it is a composite number. Write only C. 35, C in 35 is a composite number. Part B, 33. So we have to check 33 comes in which tables? Any 33. Factors are 33, 1, 3, 3, 11, and 33. It has also 4 factors, so it is a composite number. Part C, 57. Now we have to check 57 may come in which tables. So first number 1. And then there is no table which have 57. So 57 will be itself is a factor. So It has only two factors. It is a prime number. You can write answer like 57p. Question number 3, part D, 41. Comes in which tables? 1 and 41. 41 doesn't come in any table. So it has only two factors, so it is a prime number. Part E is 54. I hope you well memorize the tables. So let's check. Come with me and check. 54 comes in which tables? 1, okay, 2, 2, 27, the 54, and 6, 6, 9, the 54, same, 9, 6, the 54, and 27, and 54 itself. As it has more than two factors, so it is a composite number. And we have the last part, 83. So can you imagine 83 comes in which tables? I hope 83 comes in only one table. So it's two tables, one and itself. 83 doesn't come in any table. So this is a prime number. So this was our question number 3, in which we have to recognize the given numbers, that which number is prime number and which one is composite. So let me repeat. Prime numbers are the numbers, those have only two factors. Prime numbers are the numbers, those have only two factors. While composite numbers are the numbers, those have more than two factors. Okay. Question number 4. Think carefully, then answer this in your notebook. Are there any even prime numbers? Are there any even prime numbers? We start writing numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. This is question number 4. Part A. Okay, start writing the numbers up to 1 to 10 and see which one is prime number. This is prime number? Yes. And it is odd. Okay? This is a prime number and this is even. Prime, even numbers. This is prime but odd. This is composite. Okay, this is also composite. It has more than two factors. This is a prime number and odd. This is a composite number and even. Okay, this is a composite number and it has more than two factors, 1, 3 and 9. So it is a composite and it is odd. And so on. So we look in this line, we find only two. Only two is the prime even numbers. You know even numbers and odd numbers. The difference between even and odd numbers, these are odd numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 30, 15. These are the odd numbers. The numbers that cannot be divided by 2 are odd numbers. And the numbers that can be divided by 2 are even numbers. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and so on. These numbers can be divided by 2. They are even numbers. And these are odd numbers. Okay. Odd numbers cannot be divided by 2, while even numbers can be divided by 2. In the number line, we see only 2 is the even prime number. Only 2 is the even prime number. So, answer is, are there any even prime numbers? Yes. There is only a one even prime number, that is 2. Okay? Because 2 is an even number and it has a prime number because it has only 2 factors. Prime number why? Because it has only 2 factors. Even number why? Because it can be divided by 2. Question number 4, part B. How many composite numbers and how many prime numbers are there between 1 and 50? How many composite numbers and how many prime numbers are there between 1 and 50? You think this question? I give you 2 minutes. Think about the numbers between 1 and 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, up to 50. Okay? How many prime numbers and how many even numbers will come here? How many composite numbers do we have to count? So we'll start question number 4, part number B. So start writing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 and 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39 and 40. 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49 and 50. Now look these numbers carefully and set which numbers are composite numbers. Yani the numbers which have more than 2 factors. More than 2 factors. So 1 has only 1 factor, 2 has a prime number, it has only 2 factors. This 3 is also a prime number. So 4, I'm circling, 4 is a composite number because it has 1, 2 and 4, 3 factors. 5 is a prime number, 6 is a composite number, 7 is a prime number, 8 is a composite number. It has 1, 2, 4 and 8, 4 factors. 9 is also a composite number because it has three factors, 1, 3 and 9. Okay, 10 is also a composite number. 11 is a prime number. 12 composite because it has more than two factors, 1, 2, 6, 3, 4 and 12. Okay, 13 is a prime number, 14 is composite, 15 is a also a composite number because it has how many factors? 15, 1, 3 and 5. 16 is also a composite number. 17 is a prime number. How many 16s have factors? 1, 4, 2, 8 and 16. 17 is a prime number, 18 is composite, 19 is prime, 20 is composite. I add 22 times. No, this is 21. 21 is composite or prime? Boys, 21 is composite or prime? 21, how many factors have? 21 have 3 factors, 1, 3, 7 and 21, 4 factors. So it is a composite number. Same wise, 22 is composite, 23 is prime, it has only 2 factors, 24 is composite, 25 is composite, 26 composite, 27 composite. Why 27 is composite? Because it has 1, 3, 9 and 27, 4 factors. 28, 29 is prime number, it has only 2 factors, 1 and 29. While 30 is a composite number, 31 is prime number, it has only 2 factors. 32 is composite number because it has more than 2 factors. 33 is a composite or prime. So let's 33 is composite or prime numbers. How many factors 33 have? 1, 3, 11 and 33. It has 4 factors, so it is a composite number. 34 composite, 35 composite, 36 composite, 37 is prime number because it has only 2 factors, 1 and 37. 37 cannot be divided by any number rather than itself. Okay, 38 composite, 39 composite or prime. So let's 39 is composite or prime. 39 comes in the tables of 3, 39 comes in the table of 30. So it is a composite number. 40 composite number. This is 41. 41 is a prime number because it cannot be divided by any number. 42 is composite, 43 is prime. 44 composite, 45 composite, 46 composite, 47 prime, 48, 49, 50 are composite numbers because they can be divided by some numbers. But prime numbers are the numbers, they cannot be divided by any number other than itself. Okay? So how many composite numbers we have? 1, 2, count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. So from 1 to 50, we have 35 composite numbers. Okay, from 1 to 50 we have 35 numbers. Okay, let me reply in your homework that how many composite numbers from 1 to, how many prime numbers from 1 to 50. Okay, how many prime numbers from 1 to 50. When you will solve this question, you will easily solve the question that I asked. Now question number 5. This is fill in the blanks. Copy these sentences in your notebook and fill in the blanks. Number 1. Every prime number except which one? We already discussed. There is only one prime composite number. Every prime number. Every prime number except 2 is odd. Except 2 is odd. So only 2 is the only one prime number that is even. All other prime numbers are odd. Number B. Each prime number has exactly how many factors? Each prime number has exactly 2 factors. 1 and the number itself. Any same number. It means that the prime numbers cannot be divided by any other number. C. Number 1 is neither prime nor composite. Number one is neither a prime number nor a composite. Number 3. All composite numbers have at least how many factors? All composite numbers have at least 3 factors. Have at least 3 factors. Some numbers may have more than 3 factors. Okay, for example, 10. Number 10 have 1, 2, 5 and then 4 factors. Okay. So all composite numbers have at least 3 factors and all prime numbers will have only 2 factors. This was fill in the blanks. Now question number 6. Using patterns of your own, check whether 6 discovery is correct. Can these numbers be arranged in exact rectangles? Okay. Number 9. You see, they sit with 3 dots and each line have 3 dots, so he made 9. For number 12, he made 2 lines and he put 6 dots in each line. Okay, this is for just your enjoyment. You can make the dots, but arranging the dots in the perfect shape of a rectangle. For example, 25. I drew 25 and let's see, can we make the exact rectangle or not for the number 25. For example, I put 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. I put 5 dots. I put 5 dots in each line. Then 0, 0, 0, 0, 5, 10, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0. 4 lines, these are 20. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So, you can easily see that this is not a rectangle. This is a scale because here is also 5 dots in the column and in the row also 5 dots. So, if the length and width of any shape is equal, we don't say it is rectangle, it is a scale. It is a scale because the length of the line and the width of the line is the same. So it is called a scale. So you will make these dots and check whether they make a perfect rectangle or not. So this was today's lesson. It was about prime numbers and composite numbers. Today we learned that what are prime numbers and what are composite numbers, what is the main difference between them. And then we check how many composite numbers from 1 to 50 and how many prime numbers from 1 to 50. I left question number 4, part C, D and E for you. Your homework, question number 4. Parts C, D and E. I am writing here for your memorization homework. Question number 4. C, D and E is your homework. Hope you will easily solve these numbers. Question number C is, but what is the greatest prime number which is less than 40? So first you will write the all the numbers from 1 to 40 and then see which one is the greatest prime number. Or you can write the numbers downward from 40, 39, 38, 37, 36, 35 and see which one is the highest prime number less than 40. Okay. Question number D. What is the smallest prime number between 1 and 100? This is very easy. What is the smallest prime number between 1 and 80? If you start writing 1, 2, 3 up to 100, then you will find which is the smallest prime number. Today we also discussed, hope you will solve this question. Question number 4, part E. What is the greatest composite number below 100? What is the greatest composite number below 100? When you will write the counting from 1 to 100, then you can solve part D and E from the same counting. What is the greatest, highest composite number between 1 and 100? That must be close to 100. So this was our lesson today. Hope you understand. See you tomorrow, inshallah. And we will do page number 57, inshallah. This is about highest cover factor and least cover factor. Till now, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.